What up? Josh and Kylie are from Claus Fitness, and today we're going to be showing you 5 secrets for a great training program. Implement these and it will really help kind of amp up everything you're doing. Let's get into it. The first secret to a proper training routine is a really good warm-up, and this is a very personal thing. If you're riddled with a ton of injuries in your past, or you feel uncomfortable doing movements and you need a little bit more time, that is okay. Everyone's gonna take a little bit different kind of time periods for warming up. Some people like to just do their active warm-up, so they'll kind of, if there's benching, they'll start with a lighter weight, do the bar, hit some reps, do 135, keep going up, and they'll actively warm up that muscle. Other people, especially if you have shoulder injuries, will need to do some rotator cuff work. As you can see here, we have a great video for warming up and activating your shoulders before a workout. This makes a world of difference, so it's definitely something we recommend trying if that's an issue you struggle with. But the key here is to completely just not neglect a warm up. You don't want to just run in, jump up, hit your max, and call it a day. That's not going to be healthy. You can't just walk up. I've seen people literally load 3-4 plates up on the bar, walk up and hit it. That's a little bit brave, and you want to just warm up your muscles, warm up your joints, make sure everything's going, get some blood pumping, and get ready to hit that workout. Number 2 is to start with your compound. So at the start of your workout, you definitely want to start with your multi-muscle movements, and then you're kind of narrowing into the specifics. So let's use push day as an example. I don't necessarily want to start by just doing triceps unless that's my goal. You can also emphasize a muscle by starting it first. So if you have really, really crappy, small, teeny tiny triceps and a huge chest for whatever reason, you can neglect this rule and start with the triceps. But usually if you're trying to gain size, muscle, and physique, or even aesthetics, you're going to want to start with those compounds. Your body's fresh, it's able to do these multi-muscle movements. For instance, the bench press, we're working the chest, we're working the tricep, we're working the shoulders, the biceps are an assist on the way down, and you're getting all these different muscles being involved in the movement. So we can start with this kind of general push theme and then narrow into shoulder work, direct chest work, direct tricep work, etc. First two are a little bit more beginner, and now we're kind of narrowing into something that is more important. So you really need to understand volume. If you want a great training regimen, you have to understand volume, periodization, and peaking. All these are huge mechanisms of an effective plan. If you negate any of the following factors here, you're gonna have trouble advancing in your strength and your size. So obviously this is a little bit more complicated. Periodization essentially is just switching your rep schemes, challenging things like that. So usually when I program, I like to have little differences in accessories, but you also wanna keep the core mechanisms and movements of a routine so you can advance in them. You don't wanna be that person that's switching a routine every week. You're gonna run in circles. You're not gonna be able to advance and mature in your movements. So you wanna make sure you're periodizing your routine effectively. You're switching rep schemes, volume schemes. So for instance, you could have a phase where it's a little bit lower rep. You could be doing 5x6, and then you could have a different phase where you're really kind of pushing volume and you're peaking out with that volume. Obviously, this is a very complex topic that can go a million different ways, but this is something you need to consider, and you really need to consider how much volume you're doing in your workout. So a beginner doesn't necessarily want to be coming in doing 30 to 40 sets a workout. That's going to be ridiculous. They're going to be in the gym 3 hours, and there's a point of diminishing returns. You can only go so long while being effective, and eventually your body will tire out and you'll kind of outwork yourself, become really sore, and just be ineffective in the gym. So you need to balance all these factors, and anything can tip the scale in a negative or positive way, so be hyper aware of what you're doing. And then a little 3.5 is not all volume is created equal. You shouldn't necessarily be doing, like, let's say an arm day, you can get away with 20 to 25 sets of movement because you're trying to work those arms or smaller muscle. For instance, a set of bicep curls, the volume there and the volume behind a squat is gonna be immensely different. So if I'm doing 5 sets of 12 for squats, it's gonna take some time, that's gonna tire me right out, and that's just gonna put in work. So you can use apps and things like that to monitor how much volume you're moving, and some muscle groups can move more volume. My legs and my back, I can usually do between 60 and 90,000 pounds, whereas my arms or my chest, I'll usually only move between 30 and 60,000 pounds. And once again, this is all very complex, so if this is over your head and you don't think you're comfortable programming, definitely recommend online coaching and getting someone to help you out like us. We'd be more than happy to do that. First link in the description down below. On to the next step.
And number 4, guys, overtraining is as bad as undertraining, and if not worse. And I see this far too often. A lot of people will come into the gym, they'll do chest day today, they'll do chest day tomorrow, the chest day the day after. You've really got to build up. And similar to that last tip Josh was talking about, volume is absolutely huge, and this is something you really need to take a look at. You're not going to be able to go into the gym and constantly progress while just overtraining and overstimulating the muscles, doing chest today, chest tomorrow. You know, even a marathoner, as an example, he's not going to come into the go outside and do a marathon every single day, just like someone who's performing for a powerlifting meet isn't gonna come in every single day and hit their max reps. So you've gotta really utilize proper rest day, days. You're not going to be spending 3 hours in the gym. You've got to program accordingly and really make sure that you're progressing and not doing more than you should be doing. And last but not least, I would definitely say this is probably the most important one. Don't skip the small things, because those are the things that are going to add up the most over time. And a small example of this is just simply skipping leg day. Some people may think it's just one workout of the year, but if you create a habit of it, or if you do it too often, you guys are going to just have a huge upper body and a small lower body, or something like skipping rear delts. And this is something everyone does. I look at all the program plans. Everyone's just always doing a pushing movement, but they're never doing something that targets this little muscle back here. And that's going to cause you to push your shoulders forward and walk like a crazy person. It's not a good look, okay guys? So really pay attention to those small things, such as sleep, such as proper rest, like we already said, and just everything, you know, all in itself is gonna make you guys see great results in the gym. So that's it, guys. Make sure to click that first link in the description below if you guys wanna sign up for coaching. We guarantee we'll help you get to the next level and see great results. And subscribe if you haven't already. Peace out.